Hey, hello everyone, and welcome back to my channel named Learning to Learn. So this is my YouTube channel, as you can see, and you can follow me on Instagram, Facebook, LinkedIn, and as well as on Unacademy. I'm a verified educator on Unacademy. Right now we have n number of courses on Unacademy, specially targeting for NTA UGC NET category. So if you're preparing for NTA UGC NET, these are all the special classes which have started from 26th, and it will go till 30, and then we'll have the schedule for the next month. So before going any further, as you all are aware that we have NTA UGC NET exams from the first week of October, so all the people are requested to join these classes as much as possible, and these are 100% free classes, so you can practice various MCQs. So in this particular week we are trying to complete 100 MCQs of ICT, 200 MCQs of people and environment, 120 MCQs of audit, and 80 MCQs of account of management as well. Apart from that, if you want to join Unacademy Plus platform, which is a great platform for a detailed revision as well as for the detailed complete course of paper 1 as well as paper 2, any subject, so you can join Unacademy Plus. These are the various prices, and there is going to be a price hike for 1 month and 3 months. For 1 month and 3 months, there is going to be a price hike, so make sure you do join Unacademy Plus, and you can use Aditi Live, A-D-I-T-I-L-I-V-E, Aditi Live referral code to avail 10% discount on your Unacademy subscription. So make sure you join, and this is the entire schedule of special classes which are taking place. So these are the classes which took place from 27th to 30th. These are the classes which you can watch live free, of course. You don't even have to pay any money. So make sure you join these classes, and let's start with today's topic. Hey, hello everyone, and welcome back to my channel named Learning to Learn. So in the last class we did what are groups and what are the various kinds of groups. Now we'll be moving forward with that particular topic. So I think we were at page number 90 somewhere. Let me just check. Yes, 95. And we completed in the last what are interest group and friendship group. So the last page was 97, and now we'll be starting with the page number 98, where we'll be trying to understand, or we'll be trying to differentiate between formal groups, informal groups, and further then start to study with new topic called details about informal groups. We will understand informal groups in detail. So let's start with today's topic. Today's topic is about formal groups. Now we know what is formal group and we know what is informal group. Today we are just going to understand the difference between the two, that what exactly is the difference between formal groups and informal groups. So let's get started. The first, I'm just going to read this out and then I'm going to explain you one by one. These are the planned structures which are based on work to be carried out by employees under strict rules and regulations. So formal groups are those groups which are deliberately created by the organization or the management so that they can be followed and these employees can work so that they can you can say achieve the objectives of the organization. Now, growth does not take place in a planned way, or there is no particular work carried out by informal groups. So, as we know, informal groups are those groups which are created out of interest or hobbies or similar likes. So here informal groups are not deliberately created by the management, and yes, they are not allotted specific work, or this does not go according to the planned way. This goes according to the people, their behavior, their relationship with other people, etc. Moving forward, the formal groups are official in nature. Yes, they have specific rules and regulations, working hours, whom they have to report to, the number of hours they are going to work, the salary they are going to receive. Everything is already predetermined in a formal group. But
informal group. They are unofficial in nature without any specification of rules, regulations and working strategies. Yes. If I talk about informal groups. Informal groups have no particular hierarchy or structure, or they are based on the interest, or you could say it is based on friendship and interest. So of course there is no predetermined goals, objectives, rules, regulations or working strategy. They go according to the human behavior and nature, and they do not go according to the planned. The next difference. Formal groups emphasis is put upon specialization of jobs. The organization assigns the job on basis of qualification and talents. Yes, because he or she is the employee of your company, you're going to give various works to the employee so that he attains specialization in that particular activity. Whereas in informal, there is no work specialization and there is just mutual help or mutual cooperation between two people can be seen, but there is no predetermined assigned work, rules, regulations, etc. Moving towards the next difference, money is considered as the basic motivator or economic factor for formal groups. Yes, money is the biggest motivator in case if you are dealing with formal groups. But if you're dealing with informal groups, money is not the main motivator. Here, the human behavior, the nature, the relationship between two people, the social aspects, the social satisfaction, psychological satisfaction, that is more motivating factor to an informal group rather than a formal group. Moving forward. I'm reading point number 5. Due to job hierarchy, there is a difference between employees of the organization. Some are top level executives and other are considered as labor forces. Now, here we have a set of hierarchy, we have a structure, we have people who report to other people, but this is not the case in case of informal. Hierarchy of post and leadership style are not seen, but yes, there can be a single person who can be treated as a informal leader by informal groups, but still there is no hierarchy, there is complete lack of hierarchy. Point number 6, there is a provision of punishment. Yes, if you do not follow the rules, regulations, if you do not come on time, if you do not complete your work, there can be various kinds of negative reinforcement. It could be there might be a reduction in salary, there might be a demotion, they could even take you out of your job, that is possible. But there is no provision of such punishment in informal organizations. Informal organizations or informal relationships or informal groups, if I'm talking about, there is no such provisions for punishment if they do not psychologically or socially satisfy the other group members, or they do not talk to them, or they do not give updates. No, there is nothing like that. Last three top points to be left now. This one. The flow of communication is restricted to upper to lower. Yes, usually in formal communication, there is downward communication where top level people communicate their demands or their objectives, strategies to middle level, and middle level thus further communicates it to low level. So yes, there is a particular flow of communication from top to down, whereas there is no such communication, there is no such particular channel of communication in informal. It can go from down to up, up to down, horizontal, vertical, diagonal, anyway. There is a free flow of communication. Moving forward, formal organizations, the employees are compelled to work under some pressure, control, supervision or a boss. So yes, formal organizations have a set of rules and they have to work under certain persons, but that is not the case of informal groups. The members work in the manner which they like. You cannot force anyone in informal groups. Now, in every organization, there is only one formal group. Yes, there can be n number of informal groups. And one more difference I would like to add here is the formal groups contains the communication in written and most of the communication are correct and true. Whereas in informal communication, there is a free flow of communication. There may be more of verbal communication or non-verbal communication, as well as the communication might not be completely true. It might include various rumors, rumors, grapevine communication, confusing terms, etc. So this was the exact difference between formal organization and informal organization, or formal groups and informal groups. I hope you have understood this. This was very easy, and if you need the basics of this, you can watch the previous session. So thank you so much for this class, everyone. Take good care of yourselves. I really enjoyed making a video for you guys. And if you have any doubts, please do let me know. I'll try to solve that. Take good care of yourselves. Bye, everyone.